The early Methodist leader John Wesley says, "Give me 100 men who desire nothing but God and fear nothing but sin, and I'll change the world. I'll shake the world," he put it. You see, we want to talk about understanding the deceitfulness of sin. Scripture says that every day of our life we need to be exhorted. Exhort one another day after day, lest we be hardened by the deceitfulness of sin. It's deceitful no matter how good yesterday was. You see, you and I would never sin unless we thought something good was going to come out of it. And so we're deceived at that point of sin. Let's talk about the deceitfulness of sin. It's so deceitful that it causes us to go against God's goodness. Scripture says, "These things I'm commanding you today for your own good," Deuteronomy 10:13. If God tells me not to do something, it's his goodness saying, "I'm trying to protect you from something." If God tells me to do something, he says, "That's my finger pointing out the best path of life for you." But sin causes me, it deceives me in going against God's goodness. Sin deceives me in going against God's wisdom. As wisdom is personified in Proverbs chapter 8, he says this, "If you find me, find wisdom, you find life, and you obtain favor from the Lord. But if you sin against me," if you sin against wisdom, "you injure yourself. And those who hate me," those who hate wisdom, "love death." You see, sin is like suicidal living. It's loving death. It's injuring oneself. He says the same thing in Proverbs 9, verse 12. "If you're wise, you're wise for yourself. You benefit. If you scoff, you alone will bear it." Sin is deceitful. It causes us to go against God's goodness, to go against God's wisdom. He even says it this way in the book of Philippians. It causes us to glory in that which we ought to be ashamed of. Philippians 3:19, it says they glory in their shame. Sometimes glorying in what? Some immoral intemperaments of living. Now, a person can sometimes also glory in being a workaholic. Now, that may be something that society would applaud, but do not glory in what we should be ashamed of. If a workaholic makes what? My priorities messed up and hinders my relationships. It's not something to glory in. It's easy to have the wrong boast. Jeremiah said it this way, "Let not the wise man boast in his wisdom." He's talking about wisdom not that we get from God, but we get from the world. "Let not the mighty man boast in his might or the rich man in his riches, but let him who boasts in this, that he knows and understands me." Sin is deceitful. It can cause us to have the wrong boast and to go against God's goodness and to go against God's wisdom. God, would you send into our life today the exhortation we need, and every day, and our loved ones, Almighty God, even at this moment, that we could not be deceived by sin and be hardened by it. In Jesus' name, amen.